The next Haydn Sonata was written earlier than the first one, and it was a wedding gift for one of the princesses of Esterhazy. Now, word of advice, if I may, for those of you with long dynasties, vary the names. Somehow they were all either Paul or Nikolaus, so I can't figure out which generation of those she was a daughter of, but one of those she was a daughter. And it has, this was written in 1784. It's in two movements, and what's interesting about the first movement, it's sort of a double set of variations. There's one theme, and there's another theme, and then they both get varied. Sort of, it's an unusual form that Haydn explores once more in another work.
Thank you.
So we know from history that Haydn was a funny man, and that's a proof. Sort of interesting to me, socioculturally, how we allow ourselves to laugh in the opera, but not in the concert. And I wonder if they did when they played this music at the time, because the music is clearly funny. So laughing allowed, encouraged. What interests me about these juxtapositions is that one can argue that we humans had the same range of feelings throughout the time, but what we allow ourselves to express changes through the time. And that's the kind of interesting thing to me, how Haydn, in this very proper world, sort of has a little fun, and then he stretches the boundaries a little bit within his time. And then, of course, these other composers function in another world sometime later. So now we get to John Cage, who was also a very witty man in many ways, stretched many boundaries. This piece called The Seasons, which I discovered by accident on YouTube. Thank you, YouTube. is written in 1947, it says here, I guess so. And like so many of Cage's works, was written as a dance for Merce Cunningham very early on. And the dance is actually lost, which is kind of amazing when you think that something in relatively short amount of time since 1947 can be completely lost. But it is. And the seasons are starting from winter. Each season has a prelude, and with the first prelude comes back at the end. It's a fully written out piece. Of course, you know, Cage experimented in every possible medium, from quote unquote silence to turning radio stations and everything in between. But this is actually a fully notated piece. Hope you enjoy it.